My name is Inoke. I'm 51 years old. I live here in Sacramento, California. I have a lump on my right shoulder that is of a softball size. Welcome. I first noticed that when it was the size of maybe half of a golf ball, but I didn't think much about it. I thought it was just a little something that would go away in time. And in the last 5 years, it kind of just grew to what it is now. The lump has restricted me quite a bit. I've knocked on the shower doors when I go in, and that one hurts because it's metal and sharp. So I'm always reminded that, hey, you've got a buddy that's coming to the shower with you. Then when I'm putting on clothes, just putting on a t-shirt like I normally do, I will have to wiggle through here to push it down, you know. So that has happened quite a bit.
Let's get something for dinner, right?
Okay. Can we get a snack?
Yeah.
It has affected my family and my wife a lot, most recently because I don't really enjoy going to the supermarket or to the store as much as I usually do. Every time I go to the store, I'm always get stared at. I get weird looks all the time. Occasionally, I get a question about what it is. I try and address their question by brushing it off as an old rugby injury. My kids are affected in their own way, seeing me hurting. I feel more for my kids walking beside me when people are looking at me. I don't like them seeing people making faces at me.
Sometimes I think it hurts my dad's feelings when we see people looking at it because we see them mumbling and we don't know what they're saying. I think my dad is sad about his lump because he used to like go outside and play with us, but now he just stays inside.
Help out, please.
I'm hoping that Dr. Lee would remove this lump for me. I've been avoiding anything to do with my lump because of fear, but now it's time for me to face my fears. I want to spend as much precious time as I can with my kids. I don't want to give that up easily to something like this.
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi, babe. I am blessed with my lovely wife of 30 years, Ateva. Apart from this guy, she's been my constant companion through thick and thin.
How's your shoulder, darling? It seems like it's getting bigger, eh?
It is.
It's not getting any smaller.
Mm-hmm. I visited at least a couple of doctors that weren't sure what I had, but that it might be cancerous.
Well, you gotta start looking after yourself. I mean, you know, just the word cancer. We all know what that is. That's practically a death sentence, isn't it?
Yeah.
It was tough telling your wife and your kids that what I have could be cancerous and take me away from my family earlier than I would like to. I never got a biopsy or any follow-up on it. To me, that was it. I was kind of scared to know if that was right.
We still have small children. You know, they still need their father around. I need you around. So we need, you know, you to slow down. You know, take time for yourself, get things done, okay? Because we want you around for a long time.
It's really hard to see him with that lump, and, you know, I'm angry because it's just something that he's ignored, and I hope that Inoke hasn't waited too long to get this checked out.
I will definitely take care of it, and I do apologize. It's taken a while to get it done.
Let's get it done.
Inoke. Hi. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Where are you from? I hear a little accent.
Fiji.
Fiji. Yeah. What can I do for you today?
Well, I'm hoping that you will help me with my lump on my right shoulder has been a constant companion of mine for probably 8-9 years, but it's kind of just overgrown pretty quick in the last 5 years.
Okay. Does it cause you pain, discomfort or anything?
Discomfort, mostly. A little pain now and again.
Anything else that like kind of affects you? Like, what do you like to do in your free time?
Right, we used to do dances, like traditional dances and stuff.
Is that usually shirtless too?
Oh, we're shirtless, yeah.
This is hard to do then.
It's difficult.
Did you go and see doctors for this?
Yes, I did see a couple of doctors, and they didn't know what it was. It was sort of a scary moment for me.
Yeah.
When the first one said that it might be life-threatening or something.
That's scary.
Yeah, that is scary. So that kind of just put me off wanting to be seen.
I'm worried that his doctor told him that this bump is life-threatening. That is serious to me. I need to make sure that when I evaluate this, that there are no signs that this could really be dangerous.
May I take a look?
Of course, please, yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna lift this up if you don't mind.
The most important thing for me to do is to touch this bump, because when something is adherent or stuck to your body, that is a potentially bad sign.
This feels heavy. Well, the fact that you've had this for a decade or so, almost a decade, and you're very healthy otherwise, really kind of tells me this is likely benign.
Yeah.
You know, okay, so that's a good sign. But you know, anytime we remove something, we check to make sure it's okay.
Inoke's bump is really big, but the good news is it moves around really well. And I would think if you had a bump this big that was malignant, you likely wouldn't have survived this long. But it is really big. There's a lot of other complications that can arise removing a bump this big.
I think this very possibly can be a lipoma. It feels pretty good. I feel like today's the day that you lose this bump.
Thank you.
You're gonna use up all my Kleenex.
I'm hopeful that when the test results come back that it will be benign, because that will take a huge weight off my shoulder, worrying too much about it.
Okay. Back.
I am so ready to say goodbye to my bump after all these years.
Okay, this area is gonna get more full because we're putting numbing solution under there, and it actually is more comfortable that way. Okay, you shouldn't feel anything other than my touching you, okay?
Okay. My family's face is right in front of me right now. Even though they're miles away, they're with me in prayers. I feel way lighter. My arm feels amazing. I'm trying to contain myself right now.
Now you're gonna be able to dance.
You'd like me to show you
and
teach you how to dance? Fijians are known for their fierce warrior dances.
Yes.
But I don't want to do it because I might break something in here right now. So what I will do a Fijian folk dance.
Okay.
You and I while we sing. So Bula is greeting in Fijian.
Bula. Okay.
Bula Malaya. Bula Malaya ke viti talega. I feel overwhelmed with joy and blessed and grateful.
Bula!
Bula!
Bula
to you.
Bula.
Thank you.